After the last class, today I'm going to talk about soil. So what is soil? Soil is the loose material found on the earth's surface. It is made of organic, inorganic and dead remains of plants and animals. So there are organic materials and there are inorganic materials. There is humus. What is humus? Humus is the organic particles derived from the dead remains over time that gets decomposed and changes into dark colored materials. So these are the dead remains of plants and animals. This contributes to the fertility of the soil. They act as fertilizers to the soil and they are formed rapidly. That is, humus is formed very fast in places that has high humidity. High humidity means where there is rain, there is very humid in that places, and where there are high number of plants and animals, because if there are more number of plants and animals, then those plants and animals will die and they will fall on the ground, and this will again turn them into humus. And humus is very fertile. The places where there is more humus, plants and animals grow more. The inorganic particles of the soil is derived from rocks, gravel, sand, silt and clay. So organic materials are the dead remains of plants and animals, and the inorganic remains are the gravel and large size particles. When you look at the land or a place on the soil, you will see that there are large particles that are gravel, and then there is sand. You know what is sand? And silt and clay are finer soil that you will see. So you might have seen clay pots and clay utensils, mitti ka bartan. So these are clay, made of clay. They are fine soil. And then there is silt which has a little bit of sand in it mixed with clay. Okay. There are three different types of soil. There is sandy, loamy and clay soil. One is sandy soil, which has lot of sand in it. Then there are loamy soil, in which there is sand and clay present, and there are clay soil in which there are only clay, there is no sand present. They are very fine and they can hold a lot of water. Now we are going to talk about the formation of soil. How is the soil formed? So you already know that there is a process of weathering, there is a process of erosion by which larger rock particles breaks into smaller particles, and this smaller particle eventually turns into finer particles, that is soil. So the formation of soil is a very slow process. It takes over years and years to form 1 centimeter of soil. The weathering of rocks breaks it into smaller pieces. These are carried away by water to a new place. This is the transported soil. When the soil that is made in one place, that is a rock is broken, suppose in a high area, mountain area, when that rock is broken into smaller pieces and brought to a plain area by river, this kind of soil is known as transported soil. Transported means it has been transferred from one place to another. Then there is the residual soil, which is when the soil is weathered from a parent rock and remains there. Like suppose there is a huge rock and the huge rock got weathered and it turned into smaller and smaller particles. But the river or the water did not carry away those smaller particles or soil particles to some other place. It did not carry away. So when it didn't carry it away, so it remains there. So this is known as the residual. They do not go to some other places, while transported soil moves to some other places. The layers of soils are known as horizon. So you can see in the right hand picture, the top layer is humus. You can see dead remains of plants. Then there is topsoil. Then there is subsoil. Then there is weathered rock fragments. They are much larger in size than the subsoil, and then there is a bedrock. Those are the huge rocks that are present below us. There are 4 different types of soil distribution present in India. Like, this is a larger category of soil. There are many different subsoils also present, but you don't have to know about it. So there are four different distribution: red soil, black soil, alluvial soil and laterite soil. So first we are going to talk about the black soil. You can see in the right hand corner side of the picture that the color of the soil is black. So this is a very fertile type of soil. It is mainly found in the Deccan Plateau region of India. You can see the circle on the map. The states are Gujarat, Maharashtra and Karnataka. This soil is best suited to grow cottons. This is also known as the cotton soil. This soil is very fertile and it can grow a lot of variety of crops on it. It can grow sugarcane and also other crops. This soil can retain moisture for a long time. Like if you wet the soil for some time, it can hold the moisture for a long time. And it also becomes sticky when it is wet. Again, it cracks up when it dries. Well, like when the water dries up, the rocks, they get cracked up. So the color of this rock is black because it is said that this rock is the remains of a volcanic eruption. Like millions of years ago when there was a volcanic eruption in this portion of our land, like in the Deccan Plateau, that remain of the lava or the soil is this black soil. That is why its color is black. Then comes the alluvial soil. What is the alluvial soil? Alluvial soil is also a very fertile soil and it is a transported soil by the rivers, mainly the rivers of the northern Indian plains like the Ganga and other tributaries of Ganga. It continues till the delta region of West Bengal and the eastern part of India. You can see this green colored portion, light green colored portion on the map that has been circled is the portion where alluvial soil is present. It is found over large part of India. You can find it mostly in the northern part, and there is a great alluvial plain of India, and most of the population in India is based over here. It is formed by the deposition of sediments by river. I have told you already that rivers like Ganga, Yamuna and other rivers, they bring the silt from other places and deposit it in this plain area. Found in the northern plains and coastal plains, this is very fertile soil and this is mainly suited for agriculture. Then comes the red soil. You can see the red portion of the country in the map. This soil is red in color and it's red in color because due to the presence of iron in it. This soil has high iron content in it. That's why it is red in color. This is highly porous. Highly porous means that this land, this soil cannot hold water in it. So whenever if you put water in it, the water seeps through to the underground and there is no water in the soil. So that why it is highly porous and it cannot retain any water. This is fine grained. This soil is fine grained, which means that there are grains in it, but they are fine, not very large grains. And deep, they are not very fertile, so very less agricultural products grow over here and they need lot of artificial fertilizer to grow crops on this land. Then comes the laterite soil. This is the worst type of soil. Okay, so it is found all over the hill slopes and also in peninsular India, not on the hill slopes of Himalayas like the Kashmir and all, but on the hill slopes, the other hill slopes where there are a lot of rain. Okay, so look at this orangish portion near Rajasthan and this other places. You can see in your map on the book that this is the laterite soil. So this places have high rainfall. So what happens when there is high rainfall on the soil continuously, the upper layer or the top soil gets washed away with the rainwater. So all the minerals and nutrients, they all get washed away with the water. So they leave the soil very poor and the soil does not have any mineral or any good quality content in it. So they are found in areas in really heavy rainfall. It is performed so the laterite soil turns into a laterite soil by leaching. What is leaching? Leaching, you will see the definition later, but let me tell you, leaching is the dissolving of important minerals and nutrients from the soil due to rainwater and getting washed away. So the top most layer of the soil that has all the fertility, it gets washed away due to the heavy rain, just leaving the next layer of the soil which is not very fertile. So that is why laterite soil is very poor and very less of few things grow on it. And this soil does not retain water because most of the soil gets washed away due to heavy rain. Apart from this four, there are other types of soil. One is the desert soil that you can find in Rajasthan in the Thar desert, and there is mountain soil which you can find on the Himalayan region. Now we will talk about soil erosion. What is soil erosion? Soil erosion is the removal of upper layer of the soil. This is a serious problem. We all know that this is a serious problem. In the previous class, I have already told you about soil erosion. It is the moving away of the top layer of the soil from one place to another. Okay, this is a serious problem and it is affecting every place all over the world. You asked me, is soil erosion good? So I told you that soil erosion does only one thing good, that is it sometimes changes a highland to a plateau, and it also helps in the formation of a plain. But apart from that, everything the soil erosion does is bad. It creates the soil, it makes the soil less fertile, and gives problems in agriculture. The reason to soil erosion are over, like the reasons for which soil erosion actually happens is over agriculture, over grazing, and deforestation. When there is too much of agricultural works done on a land, or when there is overgrazing means if you leave the cattle, the cows and the goats out and they keep on eating the grasses and they eat all the grasses, leaving the land barren. This results in the removal of top layer of the soil when there is rain. So this also creates soil erosion and deforestation. What is deforestation? Deforestation is the cutting down of trees. So when there are no trees present on the land, the water easily can wash away the top layer of the soil, and there will be no blockages by the tree roots to stop the water from flowing. So this will enhance the soil erosion. This needs to be checked. That is, soil erosion needs to be checked with proper measures like afforestation, better agricultural practices, and other practices. This can stop the soil erosion. There are certain things to remember. That is, denudation, the weathering of earth surface by weathering, distributaries, river channels separating from the river, tributaries, river channels or other rivers joining into larger river, leaching, a natural process in which rainwater dissolves the minerals from the soil and carry them away, meander, sweeping curves of the rivers. Human activities are also responsible for degradation, erosion, and gradation. There are some questions that you need to answer at the end of this chapter.